pray to you today. We thank you for the opportunity you've given us and the freedom we have in our country to express ourselves and to preach your word. May this freedom continue to be in this country. Lord, we pray that don't take it away from us. In the name of Jesus. And Lord, as I minister your word, I pray that you anoint me, you anoint everyone that is hearing my voice. And Father, I pray that may your word have a place in our life today. In the name of Jesus, I pray. And let everyone say, Amen. Galatians chapter 6, verse 14. For the sake of those of you who didn't read the Bible, I told them, media people to bring the verses so that we can all read together. So let's all read together. Ready, go. But God forbid that I should boast, except in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom the world has been crucified to me, and I to the world. Again. But God forbid that I should boast, except in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom the world has been crucified to me, and I to the world. The next scripture is 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 2. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 2. If you are writing right, 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 2. I hope those who are outside are hearing my voice. Some may make sure that wherever anybody stands, you will hear my voice. 1 Corinthians 2, 2. And let's all read together. For I determined not to know anything among you, except Jesus Christ and Him crucified. Okay? For I determined not to know anything among you, except Jesus Christ and Him crucified. This is Paul speaking. Paul says that God forbid. In other words, it's a taboo to me for me to boast. He said, God forbid that I should boast. But there is one thing that if I need to boast, I will boast in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And he told the people that when I came to you, I was determined. It means I purpose in my heart that I don't want to know anything about you, but all that I want to know is Jesus and Him crucified.
Amen.
So if Paul says that he will not boast, but he's only going to boast in the cross of Jesus, first of all, we have to know whether Paul has something to boast of. Because if you don't have anything to boast of, then you can say that. It's like somebody who doesn't have money to buy food and you say that I'm fasting. You are not fasting. It's because you don't have money. That is why you are saying you are fasting. But if you have money and food is available, and you deny yourself of the food, then that is proper fasting. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Or it's like somebody who is impotent and is about to be alone. You are impotent. It is when you are alive, every part of your body is working. And you say that I don't like the game you are talking about now. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So when Paul says that, I don't want to boast, but I said in the cross of Jesus Christ. First of all, let us look at his life. Whenever he wants to boast, he has not something to boast of. In the next place, the Bible tells us that Paul, standing under a renowned philosopher at his time, called Galileo. In fact, if Paul was living at our time now, he would have more than one doctorate degree. He would be called Doctor Paul. He wrote two texts of the New Testament.
That's right.
In fact, if you take the teachings of Paul from the New Testament, we will not know how to make church.
No.
We won't know how to go about church.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
This is Paul. In fact, he was someone who said, if I want to preach, I don't want to go to a place where somebody has
Yes.
I want to go to a place where there is nobody can preach. No church can be established in this town, this village. That's the place Paul is giving to that one place I want to go. Please have my son. He will go to a place in the house where nobody has been there, where none has been able to be there. He will go to a place in the house and start a church. In fact, when we come to the first time, we talk about it in Philippians chapter 3. I want you to go Philippians chapter 3, verse 4 to 7. He makes some statements that is very, very interesting. In Philippians chapter 3, from verse 4, on the board, let's read. Ready, go. No, I also might have confidence in the flesh. He said, if I have something in the flesh to boast of, I'm telling you what I can boast of. Let's continue. If anyone else thinks he may have confidence in the flesh, I also circumcise the eighth day of the stock of Israel, of the tribe of Benjamin, a Hebrew of the Hebrews, concerning the law, the Pharisee, concerning zeal, the fruit in the church, concerning the but what things were gained to me, these are accounted loss for what? Possible, if we want to boast in the flesh. First of all, I want you to know that I was circumcised on the eighth day. And that shows that he comes from the religious family. Every religious Israelite on the eighth day, he was circumcised, not the ninth day, the eighth day. He also wants you to know that he was a true Jew, and he was circumcised on the prescribed day. He said, I come from the stock of Israel. All true Jews were direct descendants of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and they did not consider the line of Israel as pure Jews. So, he says, of a tribe of Benjamin and Joseph were not Jacob's favorite sons. They were born to Rachel, Jacob's favorite wife. Israel's first king came from the tribe of Benjamin. This is the tribe that was faithful to David during the rebellions of Absalom. He said, I am a Hebrew of the Hebrews. It means he was born to Hebrew parents and maintain the Hebrew tradition and language. Yeah. It's like when you are talking to a rabbi and you say, look, I come from the Mayuku family, and not only the Mayuku family, but he will be able to explain to you where he is coming from. That look, ask for me, I am this. Look at people who are close to the throne. Even those who are not royal, and they are just close to the throne. They watch the shoe on the floor. Even the